morning. Welcome to our city commission meeting. Looking for Pastor Tom Holcraft of Messiah Lutheran Church. No.
Good morning.
Okay.
Well, let us bow our heads for a word of prayer.
Traitor.
And we'll remain standing for our Pledge of Allegiance. Our kind Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this day that you've given us. We thank you, Father, for the citizens of our city. We thank you, Lord, that we have the opportunity to serve our citizens, Lord, and the residents of our community, Lord. Help us to make wise decisions. Lord, give us common sense and give us patience, Father. We ask this in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Mr. Rader.
Yes, sir.
Ms. Hackmeister, would you call the roll, please?
Commissioner Cady.
Here.
Commissioner Brown.
Here.
Commissioner Rader.
Here.
Commissioner Nichols.
Here.
Mayor Bradnicki.
Here. That was preacher. He's going to be late.
Well, tell him he can go to Dunkin' Donuts.
I'm sorry.
I'm just kidding.
Okay. Gentlemen, we have the minutes from the April 26th meeting. If everyone had a chance to read those minutes ahead of time. And any comments, any changes, additions, something that should have been there that's not. If not, entertain a motion to approve the minutes from April 26th.
Mayor, I'd like...
Go ahead.
I made a motion, Mayor.
I'll second the motion. Kenny?
Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Bradnicki?
Yes. Okay, we have an upcoming appointment to the Panama City Housing Authority, scheduled for May 24th. So, Mr. Ravan is in that position now. And if anyone is interested, I think, does Mr. Ravan want to stay on the board, do you know?
He has not.
He hasn't? Okay, so we need to find out if he does, and if there's someone else, if anybody else is interested, need to apply. That'll be for May 24th. Okay, at this time, we have audience participation. If there is something that you want to bring up before the commission, do so at this time. Give your name and address. And it has to be something that is not on the agenda. Okay, seeing no one, we'll go on. Darlene?
We have two ordinances amending the fire pension plan and the police pension plan. There is no impact to the plan. This is updated for legislative requirements. It also establishes a share plan. Nevin?
This is the first reading of Ordinance 2584, an ordinance of the City of Panama City, Florida, amending Chapter 2, Administration, Article 6, Employee Benefits, Division 4, Municipal Firefighters Pension Trust Fund of the Code of Ordinances of the City of Panama City, amending Section 2-396. Definitions by amending the definitions of actuarial equivalent, credited service, firefighter, and spouse, amending Section 2-398, Board of Trustees, amending Section 2-399, Finances and Fund Management, amending Section 2-401, Benefit Amounts and Eligibility, amending Section 2-403, Disability, amending Section 2-410, Maximum Pension, amending Section 2-422, Deferred Retirement Option Plan, amending Section 2-423, Prior Fire Service, adding new Section 2-425, Supplemental Benefit Component for Special Benefits, Chapter 175, Share Accounts, providing for severability of provisions, repealing all ordinances in conflict herewith, and providing an effective date.
And one more, please.
Another long one.
This is first reading of Ordinance 2585. An ordinance of the City of Panama City, Florida, amending Chapter 2, Administrative Administration, Article 6, Employee Benefits, Division 5, Municipal Police Officers Pension Trust Fund of the Code of Ordinances of the City of Panama City, amending Section 2-445, definitions by amending the definitions of actuarial equivalent, credited service, and spouse, amending Section 2-448, finances and fund management, amending Section 2-450, benefit amounts and eligibility, amending Section 2-452, disability, amending Section 2-459, maximum pension, amending Section 2-471, prior police service, amending Section 2-472, deferred retirement option plan, adding new Section 2-475, supplemental benefit component for special benefits, Chapter 185, share accounts, providing for severability of provisions, repealing all ordinances in conflict herewith, and providing an effective date.
The city received 4 proposals for banking services. The ranking was as follows. Number 1, Wells Fargo. Number 2, SunTrust Bank. Number 3, Hancock Bank. And number 4, Trustmark Bank. The staff recommendation is to award the banking services contract to Wells Fargo on a 3-year term with an option to extend the term for 2 additional 1-year terms.
Okay. Comments? Your motion?
I'll move approval of doing staff recommendation of Wells Fargo.
Mr. Mayor, I'll second the motion.
Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes. Before we go any further, Mr. Brown, is there any adjustments to the agenda today?
Yes, sir. Let me see here. Item 10D, staff is asking that item to be pulled from the agenda.
Okay. Your motion?
Hold on for a second.
Second the motion.
10B?
D.
10D.
Yeah. Oh, my bad.
Nichols second.
Okay. Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes.
And for the record, that was Mr. Rader that seconded.
Oh, okay. We get confused.
Mr. Rader seconded.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah.
Okay, we have appointments to the Board of Adjustment.
Okay.
So we have Doug Crosby, Joanne Cox, and Phoebe Masker have expressed desire to remain on the board.
I move approval that all 3 remain on the board for another term.
Second.
Okay. Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am. So we have final reading of Ordinance 2583.1, amending the future land use map of the city to reflect land use designation of mixed use at 516 North Gray Avenue. Is this a public hearing?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Does anyone like to come speak regarding 516 Gray Avenue? All right, do I hear a motion to approve this ordinance?
I'd like to move approval of it.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes.
The commission has adopted Ordinance Number 2583.1, an ordinance amending the comprehensive plan future land use map of the city to reflect a land use designation of mixed use for a parcel of property located at 516 North Gray Avenue, Panama City, Florida, providing for a repealer, providing for severability, and providing for an effective date.
Okay, we have Ordinance 2583.2, amending the zoning map of the city to direct the zoning designation of mixed use 1, property located at 516 North Gray Avenue. This is a public hearing. If anyone would like to address us on this issue. Seeing no one, do I hear a motion?
Make the motion, Mayor.
I'll second that, Mayor.
Okay, any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am.
Commission has adopted Ordinance Number 2583.2, an ordinance zoning a parcel of property located at 516 North Gray Avenue, Panama City, Florida, having approximately 0.25 acres. Mixed use one, providing for a repealer, providing for severability, and providing for an effective date.
Gentlemen, there are two items, 8A and also 9 consent agenda items. Do you want to discuss those separately? Either one. If not, your motion on the consent agenda.
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to make a motion on the consent agenda to approve.
Is there a second?
Second.
Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am. Mr. Brown?
Next item is consideration of budget amendment for the Panama City Port Authority. The amendment that you have before you would amend their capital budget, which was approved by their board at their meeting on April 28th. This amendment relates to the port's plans to purchase the existing port facilities and 41 acres of land located adjacent to the West Rock Mill. Mr. Stubbs is in the audience if you have any questions or if he would like to add anything at this time. Staff recommends approval of the amendment.
Move approval.
Second motion.
We've got a motion, second. Discussion. Mr. Nichols.
Basically, I was going to say this is just a, based on if you watch the news and what's been in the paper about what this budget amendment means to the Port Authority and West Rock, the mill, creating some additional jobs, expanding a port that's landlocked. So this is, I think, an historic event for the city of Panama City and all Bay County. So I just wanted to say that before we motion.
Absolutely. Congratulations, Mr. Stubbs. I think it is a very big deal for the city of Panama City and for the port. Okay. Any other discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am.
Next, we have consideration of the rejection of one single proposal to provide design services for the Cove Monument sign. We received a single proposal of $11,275 from the Tulo Planning Group to provide design services for the Cove Monument sign. That's approximately twice of what staff expected it to be. Therefore, staff recommends rejection of the proposal and authorize to either re-advertise or what we think we're going to do is advertise the project as a design build.
Okay. Need a vote?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Your motion?
Move approval of the rejection of the single proposal.
Second the motion.
Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am.
Next, we have consideration of ranking of consulting firms for the Panama City Marina T-Dock and Bulkhead project. We received 4 qualification statements from consulting services related to the T-Dock and Bulkhead project. A group interviewed the firms. Following those interviews, the staff recommends the following as follows: MRD, number 2, Weber Volkert, which were tied. All firms were qualified for the work. However, MRD demonstrated excellent knowledge and understanding of our project. Therefore, we need City Commission action on to accept the ranking or rank them differently and then authorize staff to negotiate a contract with the number one firm to proceed or proceed to the other firms if a reasonable contract cannot be obtained.
Okay. Do I hear a motion to approve staff's recommendation?
Move approval.
Second the motion, Mayor.
Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am.
Next is consideration of acceptance of an additive change order in the amount of $41,598.68 on the Frank Nelson Soccer Field project. This is for installation of conduit by L&R Construction to serve the field lighting, which will be installed by Musco at a later date. This change order also includes fence enclosure around the power pole, transformers installed by Gulf Power, and new water and sewer services to the concession stand. There are adequate funds in the project to do this, therefore no budget amendment is required.
Move approval.
Second.
Second.
Any discussion? Call roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am.
Next, we have consideration of authorizing the mayor or city manager to sign the easement granting Gulf Power access to parcel 13015-005-020 for construction and maintenance of power utilities related to the Jinx Avenue widening project. This is a parcel that we purchased as a result of the Jinx Avenue widening project. Gulf Power has requested a blanket easement over the entire parcel, but we'll work with staff to reduce the size and location once improvements are constructed. Staff recommends approval.
Your motion?
Make the motion, Mayor.
Second.
Any discussion? Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am.
Next item is consideration of Resolution 512016.1, which amends the budget in the amount of $5,284 for the purchase of Aimpoint Patrol Rifle Optics to replace the recalled EOTech Patrol Rifle Optics. Recall was recently issued on the EOTech Rifle Optics, which were installed on our SWAT rifles due to potential failure of the device to maintain true aim. EOTech offered a voluntary refund for those devices purchased by any agency. We immediately removed them from service upon notification and applied for the refund. We were sent a complete refund in the amount listed. Recommendation is for authorization to deposit this refund in the general fund and approve a budget amendment in account 55200 in the amount of $5,284, and also request that approval be given to those funds to purchase Aimpoint Patrol Rifle Optics to replace the recalled patrol rifle optics.
Okay, do I hear a motion?
So moved, Mayor.
Second.
Discussion. Call the roll.
Commissioner Cady?
Yes.
Commissioner Brown?
Yes.
Commissioner Rader?
Yes.
Commissioner Nichols?
Yes.
Mayor Brudnicki?
Yes, ma'am. Anything else come before the City Commission this morning?
Yes, to read the resolution.
Oh,
thank you.
Okay. Sorry.
There was the City Commission adopted a resolution, which is number 512016.1, a resolution providing for the amendment of the approved fiscal year 2015-16 budget for the City of Panama City, Florida, for the replacement of recalled patrol rifle optics.
All right. Anything else to come before us this morning? If not, we'll have CRA as soon as we can, I guess.
8:30 or 8:30.
All right, 8:30 we'll start CRA. Thank you.